In this example, we are given that the figure shows two vertical smooth rails AB and CD, which are separated by a distance L, and hence A and C are connected with a capacitor of capacitance C. Here a rod PQ of mass M is horizontally kept in touch with both the rails as shown, and it is saying that if it is released at T equal to 0 and it remains in contact with rails during the fall, we are required to find the charge on capacitor as a function of time. Now, in this situation, we can see on releasing due to its weight mg, the rod will start falling. When it attains a speed v, here we can see across terminals p and q, a motional EMF is induced, and we can directly write motional EMF across EQ is this, we can directly write as BVL if V is the instantaneous speed of the rod, due to which the capacitor will attain a charge plus and minus Q on its plates, which is due to the potential difference BVL across the capacitor. So we can directly write instantaneous charge on capacitor is this, we can write as CV, that is CBVL. And here we can see as motional EMF is increasing, the charge will also increase, due to which we can see a continuous current will flow in the circuit. And here circuit current can be directly given as I is equals to dq by dt. And on differentiating this expression, here you can see C, B and L are constants. So dq by dt will be CBL multiplied by dv by dt, which we can write as CBLA, where A can be written as the acceleration of this rod, which is dv by dt. And in this situation, due to this current, it experiences an upward magnetic force BIL. The rod will experience the force in upward direction. So here we can write, if rod acceleration is A, we can directly use acceleration as mg minus BIL divided by its mass. And in this situation, if I substitute the value of current as CBLA, this will be mg minus B square L square CA by M. And if this term is taken on the left hand side, here you can see the value of acceleration we are getting is, just for the limitation of space I am writing here, you can see this can be given as mg divided by m plus b square l square c, that is the acceleration of this rod. And we can directly write after time t, its velocity v we can write as at, that can be written as mgt divided by m plus b square l square c. And now if we wish to write the charge on capacitor, which we are required to find as a function of time, this we already written as CBLV. So on substituting the value of V here, we are getting CBL mgt divided by m plus b square l square c. So this will be the answer to this problem, the charge on capacitor as a function of time.